God didn't create us to just get by in life, to just have enough for what we need. We're grateful for that, but God is not a get-by God. He's an overflow God. He wants you to have an abundance so you can be a blessing to others. When you have so much joy, you bring joy everywhere you go. You have so many resources that you can help those around you. And you may not have seen this yet, but God is about to do a new thing. One touch of His favor will take you from having just enough to having more than enough. Now, sometimes people will try to convince us that we're not supposed to be blessed. If He wanted you to have just enough, why would His name be More Than Enough? Don't let people talk you out of the overflow. That belongs to you. Well, you say, I'm just grateful to get by. Yes, be grateful, but don't stop there. Lord, thank you that you're El Shaddai, the God of more than enough. Thank you that overflow is headed my way. The Israelites in the Old Testament were in the desert, headed towards the Promised Land. They got tired of eating manna each day that was something like bread. They went to Moses and said, they wanted meat to eat. There were 2 million people out there, no grocery stores. Moses was frustrated. He said, God, even if we butchered all of our flocks, all of our herds, we wouldn't have that much meat. God said, Moses, when did I become weak? Have I lost my power? Don't you realize I control the universe? God shifted the winds and caused millions of quail to come into their camp. For miles everywhere they looked, there were quail flying 3 feet off the ground. The scripture says they gathered them up all day and all night, and no one had less than 50 bushels of quail, or you could say 50 boxes of steak. One moment they were in lack, struggling, no sign of increase. The next moment, they were in overflow. They had more than enough. What's interesting is, quail don't normally fly that far from water. Normally, they'd never be way out in the desert. But God shifted the winds and suddenly the quail showed up. You may not see how you could ever come into overflow, how you could ever have more than enough. All God has to do is shift the winds, cause the right people to be good to you, cause the contract, the promotion, the scholarship to come your way. All the circumstances may say it's impossible. God is asking you what He asked them. When did I become weak? Is there any limit to my power? Get an agreement with God. He's about to shift some things in your favor. He's about to open a door that no person can shut. He's about to put you at the right place at the right time. He's going to cause the quail to find you. We look at our situation in the natural, but we serve a supernatural God. He has ways to increase you you've never thought out, just to shift here and suddenly you're in overflow. A shift there and suddenly blessings you cannot contain. The scripture says, when you honor God, blessings will chase you down. You don't have to look for the blessing, just keep God first place and the blessing will look for you. I believe right now, promotion is looking for you. The right people are looking for you. The healing, the scholarship, the property, the business is looking for you. It's just a matter of time before you hear that knock on your door. You weren't expecting it. You couldn't have made it happen. What was that? The God of overflow, pouring out one of those blessings that you cannot contain. This is what happened to Peter in Luke chapter 5. He had been fishing all night. He'd worked hard, done his best, and caught nothing. Early the next morning, he was on the shore, cleaning his net, when Jesus came up and asked to borrow his boat. He had never met Peter, but Peter agreed. Jesus used the boat to teach the people from the shore. When he finished, he told Peter to go back out in the water, and he would catch a great haul of fish. Well, Peter was a professional fisherman. He knew when to fish. This wasn't the right time. After all, he had already been out for hours. He almost talked himself out of it. He said, "Jesus, we've fished all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I'll go back out." Peter threw out his net. Verse 6 says, he caught so many fish that his net began to break. He had to call another boat over to help him gather up all the fish. There were so many that both boats began to sink. They barely made it back to the shore. Now, Peter had caught fish many times before, but he had never had his net break. He'd never had to call on another boat. And we've all seen God's goodness in the past. We've seen him open doors. We've seen him turn situations around. You haven't seen anything yet. God has some of these net-breaking blessings coming for you, favor that you weren't prepared for, increase in such amazing ways that you can't handle it on your own. Although you say, "I don't know if this is for me today. Last year wasn't too hot. Business is slow. I've been stuck at the same place for years." You're right where Peter was. He had worked hard all night. He had done the right thing and had no success. He was tired, frustrated, thinking he was wasting his time. Nothing looked like he was about to come into overflow. None of his circumstances said he was about to see a net-breaking blessing. Just the opposite. When it looks the worst, when you don't see any sign of things improving, stay encouraged. You're on the verge of overflow. You're close to a net-breaking blessing. Jesus said to Peter, in effect, "Just because it didn't happen last night doesn't mean it's not going to happen this morning. Just because it didn't happen last year doesn't mean it's not going to happen this year." Maybe you're where Peter was. You've worked hard. You've been faithful. You've done your best and caught nothing. Your time is coming. There weren't any fish out there last time, but God controls the fish. He knows how to cause the fish to find you. It's not too late. Business may be slow. The medical report doesn't look good. You're in a prime position for overflow. God is saying, throw that net out one more time. Start believing again. Start dreaming again. Start taking steps of faith. You don't know what God is about to do. The reason it hasn't happened yet is much bigger than what you think. It's not going to be a normal catch, an ordinary promotion, an average contract. It's going to be a net-breaking blessing, something unprecedented, favored so heavy it causes the boat to start to sink. God is going to do things in your life that astonishes you. Doors open that you never dreamed would open. He's going to put you in positions of influence and leadership that you've never imagined. He's going to give you resources, funds, opportunities like you never dreamed. God's idea of overflow is not just a little more of what you have now. It's a new dimension. It's something unprecedented, something that you've never fathomed. You may have a small cup, small faith, small dreams. If God only blessed us according to what we believed, we would never reach our potential. But God says, even if you have a small cup, even if you have small faith, that's not going to keep the big blessing coming from me. God is not going to stop pouring at the top of your cup. He's going to give you a running over blessing. And I've learned, it's not the size of your faith that will limit you. It's the quality of your character. If you will keep your heart pure before God, that doesn't mean that you're perfect. But when you make mistakes, you've asked for forgiveness, you do better the next time, you treat people right, you have a good attitude, then God can release these running over blessings, blessings that you can't fathom. It's not going to be your lack of faith that stops you. That's why the scripture says, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you can move mountains. Even when Peter went back out to fish, when Jesus told him to, he didn't think he was going to catch anything. He was just being respectful. He was just honoring Jesus. But God looks at our heart, as much as he looks at our faith. Peter may not have had the faith, but he had the heart to please God. Don't feel discouraged if you don't feel like you have enough faith. If you have small dreams, a small cup, you think you're limited by how you were raised, or about how big that obstacle is. You wish you had more faith. The good news is, God has running over blessings. Because your heart is right, your lack of faith is not going to stop the awesome future that God has in store for you. Isaiah 54 says, "Enlarge your house, build an addition, for soon you will be bursting at the seams." And you may feel like you're stuck, you don't see how you could accomplish your dreams. God is saying, soon you're going to be bursting at the seams. Soon you're going to see a net-breaking blessing. God is about to do something unusual, out of the ordinary, promotion that you can't contain, increase that causes you to explode to a new level. God knows how to get you into overflow. You don't need everybody to be for you. You just need the right people to be for you. God has already lined up these divine connections that will help you fulfill your purpose. Psalm 65 says, "God will crown the year of a bountiful harvest. Even the hard places will overflow with abundance." This overflow is not just to reach your dreams, not just to go further, but you're going to see overflow in the hard places. Maybe you're facing an illness, you're taking the treatment, or you're raising a difficult child. That is not going to defeat you. You're about to overflow with strength, overflow with healing, overflow with victory. Perhaps you're struggling with depression, anxiety, fear. That is not your destiny. You're about to overflow with joy, overflow with peace, overflow with favor. In the hard places, God promised you wouldn't overflow with abundance. That means you're not going to lack anything that you need. You're gonna have plenty of grace, plenty of joy, plenty of favor.